All right, we're at our last section of notes, and you need to title this one Energy Pyramid 2. Energy Pyramid 2. All right. So just a reminder what energy pyramids do, why we use them. They show the amount of energy. They show the amount of energy. And it shows that it decreases as you go through the food chain. Okay, this is like a vertical food chain. We have our grass, which is eaten by the cricket, which is eaten by the bird, and the bird is eaten by the snake. So this is really a vertical food chain. I want you to think about all the grass blades in the world. It's a lot, okay? That's why there's so much available energy down here. There's so much grass all over the world. Plants, trees, shrubs, vegetables, okay? That's a lot. And then I want you to think of how many snakes there are in the world. Definitely not as many as grass blades or plants, okay? And the reason why there aren't as many snakes as there are plants is because the higher you go through the food chain, the less available energy there is. So there's only enough energy for a certain amount of organisms that are high up in the food chain. And this is because as you go through, like when this grasshopper eats the grass, it's only going to absorb 10% of all the energy that's in this grass. Okay? Only 10% goes to the next organism. So where does that other 90% go? If this cricket is only getting 10% of this patch of grass, where did the other 90% go? But you have to remember that the grass has to live and reproduce, okay? 90% of energy in organisms go to movement and digestion, okay? Among other things, reproduction and things like that, okay? And so when energy, that chemical energy, is being converted to help the organism move and grow and reproduce and do the life processes, it gets converted into thermal energy. Okay? So this bird will eat this grasshopper, and that bird is only going to get 10% of the energy that this grasshopper has. And where does that other 90% go? To life processes. And because of that, it gets converted into thermal energy. Okay? So this snake is going to eat this bird. The snake is only going to get 10%. Where does that other 90% go? Into life processes and gets transferred or converted into thermal energy. Okay? Now, everything has measurement units. If we were to measure how far we walked, we could measure in feet. We could measure in miles. How much mass something has, we use grams, okay? We can measure energy as well. And that measurement is called kilocalories, okay? Kilocalories. And you've probably seen the word calories on the food that you eat, the labels, okay? We put kcal for short. And kilocalories is the measurement unit of energy, okay? Of available energy. So we got to do a little math here. Let's say that this bunch of grass here converted the sun's energy and made, 4,300 kilocalories. Okay? And because only 10% gets transferred to the next organism, the cricket that eats this grass is only going to get 10%. Here's a little math hack. Okay, 10%, you just remove the last number. Okay? So this grasshopper is only going to get 430 kilocalories. Okay? So now this bird is going to eat the grasshopper and only going to get 10% of what the grasshopper has. So now this bird is only going to get 43 kilocalories. And then the snake is going to eat the bird, but he's only going to get 10%. So he only gets 4.3 kilocalories. He's only getting a little bit of energy. This guy up here, that's why he's constantly having to spend all his time hunting and eating, okay? Because the higher, further up we go through the food chain, the less available energy, okay? There's very little energy up at this level. That's why it's in the smallest area of the pyramid. There's a lot of available energy down here. That's why it's in the biggest part of the pyramid, okay? So let's do one more example. Let's say this patch of grass converted the radiant energy from the sun, and it was 50,400 kilocalories. The bird's only going to get, or excuse me, this is a cricket or a grasshopper. The grasshopper's only going to get 10%. So that would be, see, we're going to take off that one zero here, 5,040 kilocalories. So now the bird's only going to get 10% of that. So the bird only gets 504 kilocalories. And then the snake's only going to get 10% of that number. So the snake is only going to get 50.4 kilocalories. Okay? That's it for our notes. Great job, guys.